So welcome back to the Law of Attraction. Today, we're looking at an argument against equal pay for women in the field of assisted reproduction. Lindsay Kamikahi's price-fixing lawsuit against key players in the egg donation industry was recently certified as a class action. One of the arguments in the suit is that pay for egg donors is based on the same scale as pay for sperm donors, and that it shouldn't be.
Compensation for donors is all over the place. If you live in a small town, in a different state, it's probably not much more than $3,500, $4,000. In California, the egg donor capital of the world, compensation is usually higher. Most programs start at around $7,000.
The lawsuit claims that the American Society for Reproductive Medicine set guidelines which amount to maximum price rules that many egg donor agencies have adopted, and that those rules artificially limit the market for women's pay for egg donation to between $5,000 and $10,000 max. A figure the lawsuit says is equal to the hourly rate paid to sperm donors.
Generally speaking, it takes 90 to 120 days for a first-time donor to get through to the egg retrieval, okay, and that includes the application process.
According to the lawsuit, though, there are no guidelines for the maximum amount that sperm donors should be paid. Perchick's agency, which she did not own at the time the suit was filed in 2011, is mentioned by name in the complaint, and as of now, complies with the payment guidelines.
The compensation for donors is $8,000 for the first-time donor and $10,000 for each subsequent cycle.
ASRM justifies its payment guidelines in part to stop young women from making medical decisions based on what seems like a high payout. Helen Zhao was 22 when she donated for the money.
I think you're not necessarily as thinking as much about risks to your body. And also, yeah, I mean, when you're that young, you probably still think of yourself as being kind of immortal.
Zhao, who donated in 2012, would not make the same decision today.
I think at the time it seemed like a lot of money. Now, I think I'm like $8,000 would definitely not be enough money.
Payment aside, there are side effects to consider too. Zhao describes what she experienced after egg retrieval as very, very uncomfortable.
It could hurt to walk, it could kind of hurt to eat, and just like my abdomen area was kind of starting to swell as like fluid was leaking in there, which is supposed to be normal.
For the abnormal side effects, one egg donation contract provides for an insurance policy to cover additional costs and spells out that medical risks associated with egg donation remain uncertain. If you decide that egg donation is right for you, there is no substitute for your own research. Once you're informed, you can think about things in the contract to negotiate, like whether you want to remain anonymous.
They can be open, they can be anonymous, they can be anywhere in between. Some of the people that call in want to come in and meet with the donors, others want videos, others want to Skype with the donor, and still about 50% are truly anonymous.
Another item to consider is whether you grant all rights to your eggs or if you only intend to donate to one specific couple.
Some donors will say before they start, I only want to donate to this couple. So if they're leftover embryos, I want to be informed. I don't want them to go to someone else. I like these people. I heard about them.
Legal representation and more money should be on the table too.
We don't think donors can get paid enough.
Smith says prior to this class action suit, her agency was harassed by members of the ASRM for donors being paid more than $10,000 per cycle. A rep for ASRM declined comment due to the pending lawsuit.
It's good for the couple to give them something too, because they're getting so much, the couple, from the donor.
For women who are coming here, we're the end of the line. For same-sex male couples, it's a whole different paradigm.
Perchick keeps a reminder of the special role egg donation plays in the lives of these people on a bookshelf in her office.
That's how I feel. I feel like the fat little grandmother's making a little magic for a lot of people.
While women who donate their eggs may feel a sense of joy from helping others, it's important to remember to protect your own interests too. Be aware that a contract is an opening offer that can and should be negotiated. The next hearing in the egg donation price-fixing class action suit is scheduled for December 4th in San Francisco. Make sure to tweet me any legal love issues that pique your interest for next time at Law Attraction TV.